Hello, this is Wayne Fetterman, and congratulations. You've made it all the way through the first third of the Chronicles of Fetterman. Or maybe you haven't. Maybe you're just starting here. Or maybe you started near the end of Volume 3 and you're just jumping around. I don't really know. I don't know you. I don't know your bizarre listening preferences. But I can guarantee you this. You're hearing these words right now. Don't ask me how I know that, but I do. It's kind of a gift. So let me give you a little context. It's the late 1980s. I've packed up my dreams and my brand new SAG card and moved from New York City to Los Angeles and landed in the middle of a huge glut of stand-up comedians. Let me tell you, the market was way oversaturated back then, and it was kind of tough. For example, where in New York I was getting prime weekend spots, in LA I had to MC at the Improv just to get a little stage time. I MC'd there for years. The Improv, a club where comedians perform carefully rehearsed comedy material. Now, at the time, cable and syndicated TV were churning out these, what I call comedy boom TV shows, like An Evening at the Improv, Caroline's Comedy Hour, Two Drink Minimum, George Slaughter's Comedy Club, MTV Half Hour Comedy Hour, Stand Up Spotlight, Up All Night, Good Times Cafe, Make Me Laugh, The A-List. I performed on all of those shows, and not one of those programs is still on the air today. Now, to give you a sense of the zeitgeist, I even performed on the CBS Morning Show. Yep, 7:40 a.m., which we all know is the perfect time to see stand-up. But eventually, I got called up and did some spots on The Tonight Show. So before we commence with Volume 2, you should know this. Dokken was the name of a very popular metal band in the mid-1990s.
Please visit me on my website because I just put it up. It's not fancy. It's very simple. It's You don't have to say www. It's childpredator.gov /WayneFetterman.boyscout. Please visit me. It's just a very simple. There's a straight-on shot, and then there's a profile, which I call the pensive look. And you go there and you can see, you get to see my credits, and I'm still available to work anywhere. You can book me anywhere except within 50 yards of a middle school or those laser tag places. For some reason, the judge thought that was a bad idea.